So now we're going to go into the alignment process. We've run a vibration diagnosis on this machine and we know we have a misalignment problem. So I've already mounted my sensors up on the machine. In this case, since this thing is so small, and this is a nice little trick to use in industry too, I'm going to use my magnetic brace or my dial indicator mag base as a stop. So I'm going to use it on one side and we are going to go into the shaft alignment app. And we're going to put in our dimensions and we'll take a quick measurement on this and see if we're out of alignment. So we'll give it just a second to pair up. We will adjust out our sensors as we need to make sure that they are seeing each other and at about the same angle. Go down here to the measurement and it wants to know the distance between the laser heads from the stationary to the movable, and that is 88 millimeters. The second dimension is from the center of the M sensor to the center of the coupling. And we're pretty close to 46 millimeters. Distance from the center of the M sensor to the center of the inboard foot where the shims would go, and that is 55 millimeters. And lastly, the distance from the center of the inboard foot to the center of the outboard foot. And I will use my tape measure and we can see that that is 170 millimeters. Now we have to choose the running speed. And remember, this runs about 3,600, so we'll go 3,000 to 4,000 RPM so we can set our tolerance level. And now we're ready to take our measurements. So I'm going to rotate this over to one side. I'll let my little mag base hold this still. I'll check my angles to see that they are pretty close and touch on the measurement icon. It's going to give me some guidance on what I need to do. So I've rolled over to there and now I'll take the measurement. Now I need to rotate at least 30 degrees in one way or the other. So I'm going to rotate this up toward 12 o'clock, toward vertical. Take my second measurement. And lastly, I'm going to roll back over here somewhere on the other side of the machine and take my third measurement. So obviously we're out of alignment. We have three that are out of tolerance, one kind of close, but we're going to have to shim this to fix it. So let's go ahead and do that. But before I do, I want to save this data. This is really important that you save the before and the after, just to prove that what you did made the machine better. And I'm going to name this machine Before. Now that it's saved into our tablet on the RT-300, we can go right into the shimming process. So it's telling me I need 0.45 millimeters on the inboard, both sides, and 1.7 millimeters on the outboard. So let's go ahead and do that. So now I've put in my shims that the RT-300 is called for to make my vertical correction. I'm simply going to roll my sensors over to horizontal, go into the live mode, and it's going to show me which direction I need to go and how far, and I'm just going to follow the arrows for guidance. And I'm going to use my jacking bolts to start positioning the motor, taking my time, going to the biggest arrow to making a correction. In this case, it's on the outboard, and I just want to sneak up on it and bring this machine into alignment horizontally. And that's pretty close. So now we've made our horizontal corrections. I'm going to hand tighten my bolts down, 1 to 2 to 3 to 4. And I have these numbered and I suggest you do as well. Just follow a numbering sequence each time. It really doesn't matter which one is which, as long as you establish your tightening sequence and tighten the same way each time. And I usually want to watch the screen to make sure I'm not over aggressive in my tightening, because if you tighten too much at once, you'll tend to move the motor just a little bit side to side. In our case, we don't want to do that. On this, it really isn't a big deal, but if this is a 3,000 pound motor, I don't want to be pushing it around any more than I have to. So just take your time on tightening. We got it just snug, so it looks like we're still in tolerance. So now let's take our final measurement, hopefully it's final, and see if we've corrected our misalignment problem. So I've rotated over to the 9 o'clock position. I'm going to take the first measurement. I'm going to rotate up somewhere near the 12 o'clock position. Make sure that the lasers are sitting still. I'll take the second measurement. And I'm going to rotate back over toward the 9 o'clock position. And I'll take my third measurement, and if we did our job correctly, we should have a well-aligned machine. And we do. So now we want to document this. You always want to save the before and after. So we're going to save this, and we're going to call it final. So now we've saved our before alignment and our after alignment, and we think that was the majority of what we had going on that was wrong with this machine. So the next logical step would be to remove our lasers, power the machine back on, and let's take another vibration measurement and see if we corrected our problem.